Hello everyone, we'll implement a program to get the transpose of the matrix. Now what is the transpose of the matrix? Transpose of the matrix is nothing but interchanging rows into columns. So suppose I have some matrix. Now there are two examples. First one is 5 4 3 4 0 4 7 10 3. These are the elements of the matrix. So this is 3 by 3 matrix. So first one is a square matrix. Now again, what is square matrix? Square matrix is a matrix where number of rows and number of columns are same. So first example is for square matrix. So this is the original matrix 5 4 3 4 0 4 7 10 3. Now what is the transpose of that? Transpose of that is 5 4 7 4 0 10 3 4 3. So if you see, the rows of original matrix are becoming columns of transpose matrix, and columns of original matrix, they are becoming rows. So interchanging rows and columns is nothing but transpose of the matrix. You can also have transpose of non-square matrix. Second matrix is non-square matrix because there are 4 rows and 2 columns. So number of rows and number of columns are not same. So it is 4 by 2 size matrix, and even you will get the transpose of that matrix by interchanging rows into columns. So example is shown here. Now for this I need to write a program. So how will I write a program? First of all, I will need a 2-dimensional array to store the matrix. So suppose I declare a array with size 100 100, so maximum limit I am taking, which is 100 100. So right now I am writing a generic program which will work for both square matrix as well as non-square matrix. So I will declare two dimensional arrays here. One is A, other is B. So A is to store the original matrix and B is to store the transpose of the matrix. Now original matrix A I will accept from the user. So I will ask user to enter the elements of matrix A, but before that I need to take the size of A matrix, because 100 100 is maximum limit. First I need to ask user how many rows and how many columns. So enter number of rows and columns of a matrix, and that value I will store inside the variables, say row and column. So I will declare two more variables, row and col, column, and I will scan them, scanf %d%d ampersand row comma ampersand column, and then I will actually accept the elements which I will store inside that 2-dimensional array. So I will ask user enter matrix elements, and to scan them I need to make use of two nested for loops. So I have to declare variables I and j to represent the index. So I equals to 0, I less than row, I plus plus, j equals to 0, j less than column, j plus plus. I will scan a of I z. So scanf %d ampersand a of I z, and then I will print. Suppose, okay, so I am printing the original matrix. So printf here %d, and I will print a of I j. So let me change the line after printing every row. So here it will be \n. So this will only scan and print some 2-dimensional array. So suppose I enter number of rows 2, number of columns 3, and I enter the values 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Then it is printing the matrix 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Now, code to get the transpose of matrix, I will write that here. So there what I will do, so again I told you, like, for this is the generic code where I will store the transpose of matrix into some another 2D array. So B is another 2D array. So I will interchange rows into columns, and new values I will put inside the array B. So the generic element of array A, which is A of ij, will be stored as b, will be stored inside the array B as B of ji. That means here I will write code. Again, two for loops will be there, one for I, other for j. Nested for loops will be there. I equals to 0, I less than row, I plus plus, then j equals to 0, j less than column, j plus plus, and only one line will be there which will interchange rows into columns. So b of ij equals to a of ji. So I am storing in reverse way. So you can also write something like this. It doesn't make any difference. So if I say b of ji equals to a of ij, then that is also okay. And then I will print the resultant matrix. So here I will say transpose okay, and now if I run, say 2 by 3 matrix 1 2 3 4 5 6. So now it has been stored as 1 2 3 4 5 6. Okay, because I am printing the A matrix itself, so let me print B matrix, because now I am not printing the original matrix. I need to print the transpose matrix. So 2 by 3 1 2 3 4 5 6. Okay, something is wrong here. So here now you need to change these things, because now number of rows are col and number of columns are row, because after transpose number of rows will become number of columns and number of columns will become number of rows. So now it will be 2 by 3 1 2 3 4 5 6. So it is printing the transpose. Now suppose if I want to write a function which will give me the transpose, that means here I have written the whole code inside the main function, but I want to write separate function which will get the transpose of the matrix. So for that, what I will do, for that I have to write some function which is say transpose function, and to that function I will pass both two dimensional arrays A and B. So how to pass 2D array to the function? To pass the 2D array to the function, either you can go for subscript notation or pointer notation. I will go for the pointer notation. So using pointer notation, we make use of pointer to array. So this will be the declaration. So this is the first is for A, then second thing is for B, and two more integers I will pass. Now these integers are nothing but number of rows and columns, so those two values, row and column values, I will pass to the function. So this will be a declaration of the function, and definition of this function I will write it here. So suppose first one is A array, so this is A, this one is B. So if you don't know how to pass 2D array to the function, then you can go back to my video on 2D array. So there I have shown how to pass 2D array to the function with explanation. So now the code which is responsible for getting the transpose, that means this code where I am interchanging the values, so that code will be inside the function definition. So I will remove this code from here and I will put it inside the function definition. And in the main function I will perform the function call. So first let me complete the definition. So here it will be row, then here it will be column, and now int I comma j, these are the indices, then ba, so that thing. Okay, here I need to mention the column size, since the 2D arrays are column specific. So 100 maximum limit I need to write, so 100 here and 100 here, so whatever. And here also in the declaration also I have to specify that 100 100. Now in the main function I will call this transpose function. So I will make a function call here, so transpose, and I will write only base address of A and B matrices, so A B, row value and column value. So this will be the function call. So this is the function definition, function call, and function declaration, sorry, then function call and function definition. So let me run this code. So number of rows are say 4 and number of columns are 3. So I need to enter 12 values: 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, oh sorry, say 1 again, and some value say 23. Then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Column wise, if you read, you are getting the same values because after transpose, the rows are becoming columns. So it is giving the correct output. This program is giving the correct output. Now one more last thing. Now this is the transpose function that I have written. So this code will work for any kind of matrix, like for square matrix, for non-square matrix. But for square matrix, you have one more option. Like there is no need to take another array, which is B array. Within the same array, you can perform the transpose. So let me show you how to implement that code. Suppose I create separate file. Suppose here I insert a new file which is say transpose sq. Now this program will be only for square matrix. It will work only for square matrix because I am not going to use the second array. So what I will do, I will copy this code into this another file, and I will exclude the previous file from the compilation. So how to exclude that? Right, you can right click here, you can go to the properties, and in properties excluded from build, this option you will make it as yes, and you will click on OK. So you will see the minus sign over there. That means this file is now not into the compilation. So here I will make some changes, which is for square matrix. So in case of square matrix, there is no need to take B array. Then row columns, anyways row columns are same, so there is no need to take two different variables. But right now I have declared row and columns are different, so I will keep them as it is. Then what will be the another change? Here I will pass only one array, which is A. So now transpose function will take only one array. Instead of AB, it will take only A. So there is no need to pass this argument. I will make that change in the function definition. So in the function definition also, there is no need to pass second argument. And now here I will perform the transpose. So how to perform the transpose? So if you have square matrix, then you will interchange the elements of that matrix along the diagonal of the matrix. That means suppose you have the matrix. So suppose you have this matrix, which is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, which is original matrix, then transpose of that matrix will be 1, 4, 7, 2, 5, 8, 3, 6, 9. So if you observe the input and output matrix, then you will see that along the diagonal the elements are getting swapped. That means into the original matrix and transpose matrix, diagonal elements are same, 159, but the other elements, like if you see this pair 2 and 4, then that pair is becoming 4 2 here. So along the diagonal these values are swapped, 2 4 is swapped and now it is stored as 4 2. Similarly 3 7, this pair it's swapped and it's stored as 7 3, and same way 8 6 8, it's swapped and it is they are stored as 8 6. That means to get a transpose, you will swap the elements along the diagonal. So that swap code you will write here. So here I will take one more temporary variable for swapping purpose, and here I will say temp equals to a of i j equals to a of ji, and a of ji equals to temp. Now let me check whether it is printing transpose. So if I run this, this error, so the errors are for B, So what did I? Okay, I am printing B here. So number of rows are 3, number of columns are 3, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. It is printing 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. It is printing original matrix itself. It is not printing the transpose. So what is wrong in this code? The wrong in this code is one small change I need to make here. Instead of saying j less than column, I have to say j less than I, because if I say j less than column, then the swapping will happen two times. So if you dry run that code, for ij value 0 1 there will be swapping, and for ij value 1 0 there will be again swapping. So the swapping will be performed twice. So for that you can dry run this code and you can cross check, and it will print original matrix into the output. So if I take this condition now, let me run. So number of rows 3, number of columns 3, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. The transpose is 147258369. So thank you so much for watching. I will see you again in the next video.